I understand where this is. If he can find a way to get in against Dill, those big Rob hitboxes, he's going to be able to string together a bunch of combos like this. And he already...
Immediate cape.
This man has got a game plan, and he's utilizing it already. Already up to 39% in the first 8 seconds.
Now, I know I saw this when on Twitter when Jewel did the Nixie and just like said exactly what he's going to do after an exclamation point after all of it. He did tease. He did say, might pull out the Mario with a little, like, some form of emoji. So I thought he was joking, because I haven't seen this man play any character that isn't Robin. But here it is, a Mario.
I like this move.
it's a good pick from a character standpoint. Mario's actually kind of ridiculous with amazing out of shield options, and like he can get two back airs and a short hop. His up air strings are incredible. Like, up smash out of shield kills. Like, this character is has a lot of tools, is above average in almost every possible way. Plus, Rob is the main weakness of Rob is that he's huge.
Yeah.
So.
Well said. We said, but Dill taking the early lead right here.
Catching the landing with the aerial. Dash back forward smash.
Patience right here. Look at this juggling.
He's just pulling a Robin, but they gave him a top.
Okay, we see. Dill, after being sort of shooken up early on.
We're trying to break the shield.
See, now we see Jewel kind of getting a little desperate for this kill here. Only at 104%, up smash probably wouldn't be able to kill here. And these options that Jewel are throwing out all of a sudden are putting him in a disadvantageous situation. Really opening Dill up for what he wants to do. I got another rat in my throat!
Dill, what always amazed me about Dill is just how observant he is in terms of reading the opponent's playstyles and just analyzing the situation. He knows exactly how long, no matter what percent you're at, that you have on ledge, and he's gonna poke you with that down tilt. He sees what you're trying to do, and he's gonna either jump off and throw, hit you at the top, and you miss the tech, you're dead every time. Oh, okay, footstool.
that was silly, Jewel. I like that though. But now again, Jewel just trying to find his way to get in. Dill has been keeping him on the ledge. Is he gonna go for the dunk? No, Dill's not gonna let that happen.
Yeah, this Rob plays under the stage extremely well.
We know another cape. We've seen a lot of those off of the gyro, off of the laser. That has been. I feel like at the beginning that was his game plan. It's just reflect all of his projectiles and then follow up with some of these little short hop up air combos, especially at early percentage on Rob. He's going to be able to string together a ton, but Dill has done a good job of keeping his projectiles moving, not allowing Jewel to really get in the way he wants. So he's going to go for a dunk here.
Ooh. Just enough of the disjoint to get through, to get past the down air, slow startup. Oh, a great wall jump, but the giant hitbox of Rob's dare.
That was a nice conversion off of the gyro. They're knowing exactly where he was going to be after the gyro hit. Back throw here.
As a clutch grab, he was in between Rob and the gyro, which is always a dangerous place to be. That'll do it.
Okay, good patience there by Jewel. 143 here.
Yeah, not impossible, but definitely not ideal. And top at ledge.
Needs to be careful with this recovery here.
He's dead.
Up throw, yeah. I was thinking maybe he might go for down throw into up smash or up air, but I was like, if in that situation off of the Pokemon Stadium 2 platforms, at once, what was he, at 162, 163? At that point, yeah, you might as well just go for it. Yeah. Might as well just go
If you have a kill throw and they'll die to it, like, I'm sorry,
I'm just gonna do that.
I know it's lame. Like, no one is hype for a kill throw.
No. Well, sometimes kill throws are hype.
I guess in context, it's like a big upset. Sure.
Who has a hype kill throw? I don't know. Maybe you're right.
Context excluded. Like, there's always gonna be context where there's like a guy Dill plays Rob and he beats Mars with a kill throw. Like, yeah, that's hype as hell.
In the process of banning stages here, is going to ban PS2.
Ban Stadium.
Ban Stadium. Probably going to ban.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I was going to say either Battlefield or Yoshi's Story. So, probably going to see. Assuming he's going to switch back to the Robin.
Yeah.
I don't think the Mario was really the.
No.
Never mind.
No. Commit. I like the commit, because you know this is why you picked up the character. Whether it's a Dill counterpick or just a Rob counterpick, this is why you have the character. And the best way to try it out is against the best Rob in this venue.
I guess we're gonna go for it here. And already an immediate gameplay change, starting with three fireballs instead of the run and gun cape into up air combo.
Which makes sense.
Jewel deciding to take it a little more slower, which makes sense. Like right now, we see just him hanging on ledge, running from side to side, making Dill come in. He's like, you know what? I'm going to make you make a mistake. And Dill says, okay, I'm just going to continue to do what I want to do.
Yeah, he's giving Dill a lot more room to play around with his top, play around with his items. But that also means that when he gets a conversion, he's going to be looking for the most optimal one. And so that'll lead to a lot more big strings of damage instead of a lot of smaller strings.
Here we go.
Speaking of up airs.
Rob, big body. Even at 63%, Jewel able to rank up a bunch of these down air. Oh, no. Good recovery there by Jewel. Mistiming there by Dill as well. Oh, he gives him with the laser.
That's it.
Beautiful catch with the side B there. Only 63% on his first stock. Jewel taking the step back. Early in the stock here, misses with both of those aerials. That was a conversion he really needed to get. Won't be able to kill here with the uppie here, but racks him up to 93%. We'll be able to get bad. No, Jewel. You hate to see it, Ooble. But
he didn't reverse it in time. Or he didn't reverse it at all. And Dill, being as smart as he is, he's not going to hit you and save you. He's just going to let you drop.
And now Jewel in a situation where he kind of has to get some. You like that interaction right there?
Yeah, staring in the face of these giant robot arms. Oh! The wall jump fair.
Sorry, I heard a little crackle there, but Jewel still finding a way to make this exciting. The wall jump forward air, bringing it back to two stocks to one, but still. Dill really has no reason to change up his game plan at all. He's running back and forth.
Yeah, Rob
with these down tilts, throw out a gyro, throw out a laser. Make Jewel to make the mistake.
Rob has a lot of safe poking tools. He has a lot of. He has two really solid projectiles. He has no reason to risk getting comboed to 125 like Jewel is right now.
Well, again, gyro coming out. Comes on his winner's bracket stock here. And again, yeah. Why did you go for that crazy off stage forward air? There was no reason for. He was probably looking for a back air, but he just happened to turn himself around without realizing it. I think that's kind of what happened to the second stock as well.
It could have been a misinput. It could have been just like you're down like 2.5 stocks. You need a big play.
One way or another, Jewel, that character needs work.